Meg, you chased the story to Brick, where the construction of a seawall intended to protect the shore community was interrupted by something unbelievable. What do you got?
That's right. So I went on a treasure hunt in Brick Township's Normandy Beach, the site of a shipwreck. Well, they may have hit history gold. If archaeologists determine that the wreck found is the Ayrshire, a ship that ran aground on Squan Beach, which this beach was once called, during a superstorm in the 1850s, this could be of huge historical significance. So I chased this story down the shore, and on site was Brick Township's Deputy Office of Emergency Management Coordinator, Joe Pawlowicz, who says the work crew was putting in that steel wall, and then they hit something that actually broke the machine that they were using.
They came across an object that was about 20 feet down in the ground. They decided to dig up to see what they were hitting, and they unveiled it as possibly a ship.
Next up, I went to New Jersey's Shipwreck Museum. It turns out New Jersey has a large history of wrecks on our coastline.
About 95% of our artifacts come from New Jersey wrecks.
So on site was a barrel-shaped object. It's called a windlass, which was used on sailing vessels for almost 300 years.
This is a windlass, and it's used to raise the anchor chain of a vessel.
The exact picture that he showed me in this book resembled exactly the piece of machinery from the ship that I saw on the beach.
Now, if you go down to the site and you look at what was recovered, you'll notice these end pieces. You'll also notice this tapered shape with two sets of iron gear teeth.
So the Ayrshire was not a complete disaster. 200 immigrants from England and Ireland survived, got off that ship
before it
wrecked on shore.
It was the first time a device called the Francis Life Card was used. This device allowed victims of a shipwreck to go inside this device and be towed back and forth from the ship to the beach.
It's a huge historical significance because the people who rescued these people now are known as the Coast Guard. So they used a boat with
swim.
A pulley system to rescue the passengers four by four in this little boat and get them on shore. They only lost one person.
It's amazing.
If this is indeed the Ayrshire, that's quite a find.
He suspects that underneath this windlass could be buried treasure. We could have cargo full of gold.
I don't know. I don't know how much gold the immigrants were carrying when they came over here, but I'm more interested in, to me, now it's going to delay the construction of the seawall. So can they just kind of pull it up and move it aside so they can finish the seawall?
Well, archaeologists from the state and the DEP are coming in to examine this to see if it is that ship.
God.
And if it is, then it's going to take some time to
DEP bureaucrats.
Can we
just leave it there?
It's a
cool story. It's a piece of history, but I'm actually being serious. It's not like it's a sacred site where there are bodies in there. This is not, you know, it's a ship, and I think the more important priority is to make sure the seawall is complete because, you know, we're going to have another storm at some point.
It's my passion.
Yeah, I can tell.